My name is Karin from Extraordinary Fitness, and today we are going to work on the reverse clock split. At least that's the name I know. So if you know another name for this trick, please leave it in the comments below, because I'm not 100% sure how this trick is called. I learned it like the reverse clock split, but I know there's always many names for each trick. So let's start. This one is, first of all, if you want to try this one, you need to have a strong elbow hang. So you need to work on your elbow hang, condition it so you should feel really safe to hang in it, even a little bit in different position, because you will hang in the elbow and then kind of turn your body downward. So it's kind of this position you will have, and it's only hanging there. So I strongly recommend, if you want to try this move, be sure you have a strong elbow hang. Be sure you have been hanging and trying around a bit, moving your weight, so you're sure of it. Or if you have the possibility, you hang the hoop really down on the floor and you try it on the bottom. So you can try the movement, and I will show you that afterwards. So if you feel sure with it, you are going to go with whatever leg is going to go behind your shoulder, will hang in the hoop. For me, it will be my left leg, which means my left elbow is going to hang in the hoop as well. So place yourself there, hang your leg, which is going to hang behind your shoulder, elbow of the arm, which is going to be the one which is holding same leg, same arm. The other hand in the beginning will hold the hoop, because it helps you to lift your leg over your arm. In that moment, you have to let go, get your arm around your back, grab the hands, close them, and then you kind of pull your leg back and you straighten your front leg and look up. For going out, you bend the leg, release the hand, go back to the hoop, and then you come out. It's not that easy to talk while doing it, so I will tell you some points which are important to think about before we do it again. So the leg which you are going to place over your shoulder, your arm, has to just be on the upper arm. So it has to be above your elbow towards your shoulder. Again, this is a little bit depending on your flexibility, but you will kind of push your leg when you straighten it against your arm. So this is one thing you should think about. Second thing is, you have to release your hand to go around and grab here and close your fingers in order to get the trick. So there is a moment where there's a lot of weight on your elbow, and that's why I want you to condition it. It is when you let go of this hand, when your leg is still bent, and you have to go around to close this one. What is next is that you are pointing your back leg, and it's not just straightening it, it is really activating your glutes and kind of lifting it a little bit backwards if you want to get a straight line. Your front leg, you push into the arm, which straightens it. So it's kind of this pushing feeling of straightening your leg, activating your glutes for the back leg, and kind of lifting it a little bit. You can turn your upper body a little bit, your chest, and look upwards. And there you are in the split. For coming out, take your hand back. First, of course, release your hands behind your back, take the hand back, and then you come down with your legs, and then you release your other hand from the elbow to the hand. I will show it to you one more time. I will show you the nothing in on the floor as well. I am in the lucky position that I have a motor, which means I can just take it down, and it can help you to just get a feeling for it before you are able to hold it. So same thing, I'm having it really low. It's like almost just a bent arm high. I'm going to put my leg in, I'm going to put the elbow there, other hand is there. Now I'm placing the leg over my arm. As you can see, I'm trying to get it as high to the shoulder as possible. It feels more comfortable. And then when I release my hand, this hand has to go behind my back. This is also important. So the movement you have to do once you release the hoop is to bring the arm behind your back. Then this hand has to go around and grab, and then you straighten the both legs. In that way, you can train this move, then release, come back, and go out. So in that way, you can at least try to find the position with your hands, how to close, how you have to do this movement to get your arm behind your back in order to be able to close, and how to straighten your legs and feel the flexibility, the strength, and the positioning. And then once you feel ready, you put it higher up, a little bit higher at least, and you try it again. You can still do it somewhere on the floor so you feel safe. So again, put your leg over, put your arm over, put the leg here. You kind of have to pull to put your leg over. Now I have to do this motion of getting my hands behind my back, close, push my, activate my glutes, straighten the legs, and there it is. Releasing the hand, coming back, and lifting out the leg. And then you have your reverse clock split. This is all for this week. I really hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Make sure your shoulder is conditioned because you have to move it back. You have to move it back front, so it's not just the elbow hang. It's a moving around in it. Make sure you're strong. Skin the cats is a great conditioning. Trying it on the floor is great in order to figure out the movement. And then take it up once you feel sure. If you like the tutorial, give me a thumb up. Follow me on social medias, extraordinary.fitness on Instagram. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and check out next week's tutorial on Wednesday. Bye.